Hello everyone and welcome again to my next Sunday episode of Quick and Easy. I will directly move on to my presentation because I will take a bit of extra time in explaining the today's concept. And today you will be learning about the different process control methods. So let me share my screen. Before understanding the different process control methods, we need to understand two concepts, defect and error condition. Let us understand this quickly with the help of a simple example. Imagine you are cooking on a Sunday to help your wife or your mother, and suddenly your phone rings. You spend time with your phone, you forget that something was on the stove, and then suddenly the food burns. So the burned food is the defect, and the error condition is forgetting to shut off the stove. So the best control in this case would have been if there was a process where the stove would have auto shut off when the food was cooked. So if this was the case, then the error condition is being removed and the defect of burning food would have been avoided. So the intention of control method is to control the error condition and not correcting the defect. I hope this concept of defect versus error condition is clear to you. So now let's move into the next phase of the video. So if you create a scale starting with the best side on the left and then moving towards the worst side on the right, then you can scale the different control methods. So these are the most popular control method, you can say, in a ranking where Pokayoke Jidoka SPC is towards the best side and inspection, SOP and warning bell are towards the worst side. So now you can ask me a question whether this ranking is provided by me, but the answer is this ranking is not provided by me, but this ranking are explained in this manner in the fundamentals of Six Sigma. So let us understand quickly each of these control methods to understand what are those control methods and why they are rated either best or worst. So we'll start with Pokayoke and Jidoka. Pokayoke is also known as mistake proving, or it is also known as fool proving, where the countermeasure is designed in such a way that a person is not allowed to make any mistake or the defect is prevented from being even occurred. So in this condition, this control of auto shut off in the stove would have acted as a Pokayoke control, and this would have avoided creating the defect of burnt food. So there are many examples of Pokayoke, so which you can find easily in Google or different YouTube videos. The next process control method is Jidoka, where Pokayoke is used as a defect prevention technique. Jidoka is used as a defect detection technique. But the important point of Jidoka, and Jidoka can be considered as a strong process control only when there is an automated process of detecting the defect and not a manual process. And once the defect is getting detected through this automated process, the line gets stopped and the defect is not allowed to move from one place to another place or from one workstation to another workstation until the defect is corrected. The third best control method is known as SPC, statistical process control. And statistical process control is used to monitor and predict out of control conditions with the help of control charts in a manufacturing process. So if you consider a system where there is an input material and then there is a process, manufacturing process, which is converting the input material into a final product. So the initial phase of this entire system are having process characteristics which can be controlled, and the output or the final product is having product characteristics which cannot be controlled but can be monitored. But with the help of statistical process control, you can monitor the process characteristics and you can control the out of control conditions with the help of statistical process charts. So SPC is a big subject where it has been extensively explained in a Six Sigma training. But if you want to apply statistical process control, you can pick few simple charts like X bar charts, and then you can use them in your process. But one thing we have to understand that SPC are having different levels in implementation. So the best SPC is the one where the operators and the staff are fully trained and they are empowered to stop the line when the process moves out of the control. And the other level of SPC, which are not the best type of SPC, are used in a manufacturing process, but there are no action or reaction on the control conditions which are moving out of the control limits. So we have to remember that implementation of SPC is directly linked with the empowerment and the knowledge of the operator and the staff. The fourth control method is inspection. So we all know about quality inspection. Quality inspection is not a good control method or not a bad control method, because it is used to inspect and segregate or differentiate what is good and what is bad. So in this differentiation, it always depends on the person who is working, and it depends on the accuracy of the person or the ability of the person to see and inspect what is right and what is wrong. Also, inspection is used as a containment solution and is a reactive approach, and therefore it comes towards the worst side when you scale the best control method and the worst control method. The second worst control method is standard operating procedure. So standard operating procedure is a set of rules or set of processes which are predefined and which are given to an operator to study, read before performing different operations. So this is not considered as one of the best control methods, because it depends on the human behavior, how they read them before performing a particular operation. And also it has been seen that SOP generally obsolete when the process evolved. So this SOP is not considered to be a good control method, although SOP is required in a process as an information system and not as a control system. The worst control method is the warning bells or the endons in the form of buzzers and flashing lights. So this I can explain with the help of alarm clock, what we use to wake up in the morning. So whether we respect the alarm clock or we don't respect the alarm clock highly depends on the behavior of ourselves. Similarly, in a manufacturing process, whether we respect the warning bell or the endons highly depends on the discipline or the human behavior of the people working in the manufacturing process. And it has been seen that as the signal offers very often, therefore the people who are working in the manufacturing process becomes immune or simply disconnect and keep the work going on even when the defect is being highlighted with the help of warning bell or endons. So since this control method is highly dependent on the human behavior, this is considered to be the worst control method amongst the ones what we have discussed in today's video. So with this, I conclude today's video, where I tried to explain the different control methods and why they are the best control methods and why they are the worst control methods. Thank you for watching the video. I hope you liked the video and understood about the different process control methods. I took a bit extra time in explaining today, but I hope it was worth taking that extra time and explaining you in a detailed manner. Thank you for watching the video again, and take care. Have a nice Sunday, and don't forget, tagra raho.